Now, friends, we have seen that Zechariah has definitely been the prophet of hope. Actually, his name means the Lord remembers. It's quite interesting that he's one of the last voices in the Old Testament to speak for God. And the New Testament opens actually with the angel appearing to a man by the name of Zechariah, the husband of Elizabeth that gave birth to John the Baptist. And therefore, it seems like this word God remembers, and this man here is a prophet of hope. But as also it's been called our attention, that he's not only a prophet of hope, because that could be a false hope, and that's the thing the false prophets had done, had given them a false hope. Therefore, this man, he's the prophet of truth also, and he's emphasized this matter of truth. And this 11th chapter that we got into last time brings us up to the Roman period. And during that period, and even before it, the Maccabean period, there would be a very dark period. Now, verse 7 of chapter 11 of Zechariah opens with this language, "And I will feed the flock of slaughter." Here we are again. Now, what we have here is something that actually is very difficult to interpret, and this difference of opinion. Did this man, Zechariah, actually become a shepherd during this time? Because as you read on down, "And I will feed the flock of slaughter, even you, O poor of the flock." And that little flock, that small group out of the 12 tribes had returned. And he says, "And I took unto me two staves, the one I called Beauty, and the other I called Bands, and I fed the flock." Now, this is quite interesting. Did he actually do this? Did he act this out? Or was this parabolic, or just a parable that he's giving? Now, I personally take the position that he acted this out, but it's a parable in action. And you find that there were several of the prophets that did that. We have seen before that Ezekiel did that. Now, you remember he went and locked himself in the house, and he came out digging a trench, and he came up in the street outside. Now, here in Pasadena, where I live, there's nothing new about digging up streets. I think now every street in the city has been dug up sometimes during the past year. But they may have missed one or two, but I doubt it. But in that day, it was unusual. And I'm of the opinion it'd be unusual today if somebody locked himself in his house and then came up in the street out there. Well, Ezekiel did that, and he had a message when he came up, and he also had a crowd. That was a good crowd getter. And I'm of the opinion that Zechariah, for this remnant, is doing the same thing. Now, we're told here, he takes two staves. Now, the one I call Beauty, that's a shepherd's crook. It means grace. That's the one that the shepherd used to keep a little sheep in line. If they started to go out of the way, just reach out of that crook and pull them right back in if they got in danger. It speaks of grace. In fact, it means that. He called it Beauty, which really is graciousness or grace. And then the other I call Bands. Now, that word here, where he says I call it Bands, that's probably as good a translation as I think that we have anywhere. I call it Bands, and it has to do with a covenant, the making of a covenant. Now, that speaks of another stick, if you let me use that common expression, just a plain stick that the shepherd also had. Now, that was a heavy stick, not like the crook of the shepherd. It was a heavy one, and he used that to beat off and fight off any animals. You remember David said when he was a shepherd boy, a lion came and he fought him off, and a bear came and he fought him off. Now, a shepherd was constantly encountering wild beasts and even human beings that would try to steal the sheep, and he didn't mind using that heavy club. So that we have here Beauty and bands are grace, and bands are covenant. Then I fed the flock. I think that he went through this literally.